I'm really, really glad to be here today. I appreciate USA Swimming, Peter Clark, and Jennifer Thomas for inviting me up here to come up here and talk to you guys. It's always good to get out, be able to share my story with you guys. Right after college, I made my first national team, the 01 World University Games. Went to World University Games and I was silver medalist there. I never dreamed, and I had my wildest dreams, I'd go to China and, you know, get to have a cap with my name on it. And that was a great feeling, but I decided that, okay, you know, I'm gonna relocate out to California and you know, take swimming seriously and try to make the Olympic team in 2004. I hit a little bit of a bump in the road in January of 03. I had an out of competition drug test and I tested positive on it. At that time, I knew I hadn't taken any type of prohibited substance whatsoever. I mean, I knew that 100%, but I'm sitting there as an athlete and I'm, well, where did this come from? As you could imagine, I mean, I was just in complete shock. You know, you get, you know, a FedEx package on your front doorstep saying you tested positive for a drug test. I mean, it truly knocked me off my feet. And so through that whole investigation process and whatnot, I mean, really the only thing at that point, because I knew I hadn't knowingly taken anything, I was probably pretty sure it didn't come from food, that it had to be the supplements. It was a multivitamin that was the culprit, and it was contaminated with three different steroid precursors, which, when you think about it, it's a multivitamin, and this thing's got things in it that, when they're excreted in your urine, they show up as a injectable steroid. What was allowed of this is you were allowed to have basically 2 nanograms per milliliter of urine of the stuff. So when they pipette a milliliter of the urine, you're allowed to have 2 nanograms, and it's a billionth of a gram. So your body endogenously produces this stuff, like most hormones, but you're only allowed to have so much of it. I only had like 3.2 or 3.3. So I had 1.3 billionths of a gram more than I should have of this stuff. So it was absolutely nothing. But I was held as accountable as someone who's like associated in the Balco stuff. You know, those people who were knowingly taking designer steroids. I had to go to an arbitration to try to prove my innocence for eligibility purposes to stay in the sport, because I mean, that's how they handle it. The Court of Arbitration for Sport and USADA, they basically hold an arbitration, and USADA prosecuted me. Because you know, they're the people that control all the drug testing here in the U.S. And I had to get a lawyer. It cost $50,000 to defend myself just to try to stay eligible in swimming. And if I didn't have understanding parents, if I didn't have, you know, people that were willing to support me there, especially my parents financially, I wouldn't be here talking to you today. There's absolutely no way I could have come up with that money. After this was all over with, I was pretty burnt. I got a 4-year suspension. That was kind of the verdict that came down. And I got that verdict on my birthday on June 23rd in 2003. So it wasn't that good of a birthday as you could imagine. You know, they told me I couldn't go to Pan American Games. And at that point, obviously, I'm not going to Olympic trials in 2004. And you know, I was 24, 25 years old. I mean, that was my best shot to make the Olympic team. After my first arbitration, I didn't have the information that the supplements were contaminated, because at that point, we didn't think that's what it was. My parents and, you know, my attorney kind of encouraged me, hey, why don't we get these supplements tested? So I sent these three supplements to an independent lab, had them tested. My attorney calls me and says, kicker, I got the information on the supplements. The amino acid, it came back negative. And I'm like, okay, well, you know, I'll have to live the rest of my life not knowing where this stuff came from. He's like, but the multivitamin came back positive, not only for one steroid precursor, but three. And I'm just, are you kidding me? Like, the multivitamin is the last thing that I would have thought would have caused that problem. With that information, I said, okay, I want to appeal my decision. So I went to an appeal case in Denver that fall in November. And even with that information that I presented, the panel recognized that the only reason I tested positive was because of the multivitamin, but because of strict liability, I was held accountable for what was in my system. My suspension was reduced because at that time, USADA had to adopt the World Anti-Doping rules, which is a 2-year suspension for a first time steroid positive. The only fight that I had at that point was with the supplement company. And so I took them to court, took them to civil court. I won the civil suit against them. And then I got some positive press out of it, because at that point it wasn't about swimming. It was about my name, my family's name, my integrity, and my reputation. And that's the most important thing in life. When you're associated with steroids, drugs, and cheating in your sport, You know, if someone's basically calling into question your integrity and who you are as a person and your character, and I had a huge problem with that. I took responsibility for taking the vitamin, but someone had to take responsibility for what was in it. But at the end of the day, there's a lot of joy in the fact that, you know, I was physically and mentally strong enough, and I had supportive family and friends, and, you know, and had strong enough faith to get through that hard time.